the Lord Jesus Christ, when he was nailed to the tree? What kept him from being tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine? Wasn't he needing life when he was nailed to the tree? Did you hear the voice of the serpent telling him he lacked? If you are the Son of God, come down off the tree. Did you see the serpent pointing at the death that come upon him? Do you see the serpent telling him God wasn't with him? God lacks and you lack the life you long for. You don't have life, you need it, and God ain't gonna give it to you. You see how he was trying to fill him with lack, to toss him to and fro with every wind of doctrine? Jesus sat in the place where he desired life. He desired peace. He desired to be comforted. He says, I thirst on the cross. I thirst. He also says in Matthew, blessed are those who hunger and thirst after God's righteousness to comfort them. When he said he thirsted, the world came with a sponge that was filled with an elixir that could comfort your flesh. And so they offered him the elixir from the world, the thing from the world that could comfort him, a strange doctrine. And he spit it out. He wasn't hungering after the comfort that comes from the world and its systems. He hungered and thirsted after God's righteousness to give him the peace and the life and the comfort that he longed for. And so he wasn't tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine. He mixed his desire for comfort, for peace, for joy. He mixed it with the faith that's been from the beginning that created all things. You see that? Jesus was trying to be tossed to and fro. That's how you do it. When the person needs life, that's when you come with the strange beliefs. Because they're really wanting life. The serpent was trying to produce lust in Jesus. Come down off the cross. Save yourself. Use your ability. Give yourself peace. Clothe upon yourself with life. That's what you want, isn't it? That is what he wanted. But he didn't mix it with his own ability. He didn't fornicate with his own strength to try to produce the fruit he needed. But rather, he mixed his longing for life with the God of all glory, the Father of light, the one with whom he'd been with from the beginning. And he actually said, no, you don't understand. I don't desire just to come off this cross. I desire to have a body that can never die again. I desire glorified immortal flesh. And even should I come down off this cross, that won't glorify my flesh with the life that I need. The peace that I need, the comfort that I need is not found in this elixir that you gave me to numb my senses. The comfort that I need is found in knowing that the Father will produce a life in me that can never die again. Abba! You see?